Hi friends, welcome to Light Art and another episode of my mixed media background series. Today we'll be talking about stencils, and since there's million and one way to do it, I'll try to make it short and understandable. So I divided stenciling for you in two little categories. I call them quick and slow. The quickest way how to stencil, in my opinion, are the sprays and blow pens and things like that. You don't even have to buy the sprays, you can make them at home, just like I did with the yellow one. It's just a little bit of rubbing alcohol and couple drops of yellow ink, or you can use the inside of a marker or even food coloring, any kind of pigment you have. Let me know if you want to see a video on how to make sprays and I'll make one. It's really easy and no problem at all. I have another spray here I made and it doesn't really spray that well, so yeah, it's not great, but it doesn't matter, it's just texture. And another extremely fast way to stencil are blow pens. I heard you guys in US don't really know what they are. It's just a marker inside this tube. You blow in here and the paint comes out. It's sort of like airbrush or something like that. Sorry, I have to stick my head in the frame. See? Easy peasy. So that's one background done, and it took me what? 3 minutes? Something like that. And the second way that I call slow is using all kinds of tools. The one I use most often is a stencil brush and all kinds of sponges. This is makeup sponge, dish sponge, or you can buy these already made ones. I found these really squishy and kind of hard to work with. I much prefer the makeup ones. Or if you have it, you can use the blending tool, of course. And I'm sure you can remember when I showed you the reverse resist technique. You know, when I use the baby wipe to lift the color from the background. This is the same technique, but just the opposite. And with this technique you can do this kind of ombre effect. If you're heavy-handed on the sides and really really lightly handed in the middle, you'll get this awesome gradient effect. Those were the sponges. Right, I dried it a little bit and now we can go to town. These two are my favorite stencils in the whole world. there by the crafters workshop, and they're so extremely versatile. You can use them for anything you want, and they have so much choices in them. All kinds of splatter and textures. Love it. You can put out a little bit of brown acrylic paint. Take your brush and pounce away. And the thing I like the most about these is when you have a really dry brush and you get these just shadows of a pattern. That's my favorite part. If you don't have acrylic paint, you can take colored pencils and trace it like this. It will take you some time, but you can do it. See? Or you can buy some of these color sticks or markers or just the cheap watercolors and take your finger and go to town. No problem whatsoever. So, you know, there's tons of choices on the market right now. But you're thinking, what if I don't want to spend the money on the stencils? What if I don't have it? That's not a problem at all. Do you remember when we talked about texture tools? The very helpful things you can find around the house? Guess what? It's the same with stencils. Look at this. Fly's water. This is like a drywall thing. This used to be a mat you put under your pots. Guess what you can do? Stencil. Stencil. And you guessed it, stencil. So don't feel intimidated when you don't have enough money or you don't want to spend the money. Just think about it and look around you. You'll find tons of useful things. Plus, with a little patience, you can make your own stencils, just like I did here. Do you remember my Doctor Who video? That's exactly what I did. Alright, I think I covered everything I wanted. And if you have some questions or you want to see something from me, leave me a comment down below and I'll make a video for you. It's kind of a big subject, so I hope I got everything important in. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my videos, please give me a thumbs up, share with your creative friends, and leave me a comment. I love reading them and responding to them. And if you'd like to, please subscribe. Remember to be weird, it's so much fun. And I'll see you next time. Bye!